Hi, I'm Chef Costa Magoulas. Tonight, we're going to enjoy some great Southern cooking, which includes an amazing, easy key lime pie that anyone can make. You don't want to miss this edition. Stay tuned. Welcome to a Local Flavor Restaurant Edition. I'm Chef Costa Magoulas, and joining me tonight is Richard Coleman from the Blackwater Inn. Welcome to the show, Richard.
Thank you for having me, Chef.
We're really glad you came down. Tell us about the restaurant. Where is it located?
We're located almost smack dab in between Ormond Beach and Ocala.
It's not a long drive to get over there.
No, certainly not. But we like to think we're worth the trip.
I think so. I've been over there several times. Mm-hmm. Tell me about the restaurant. I mean, it's a little bit about the decor and everything.
Okay. We're located right on the St. John's River. You can get there by river or you can get there by car.
Oh, wow. That's neat.
Yeah. We have two restaurants in one, actually. Downstairs is Blackwater Inn and upstairs is Williams Landing.
Well, before we go any further, I want to remind everyone this is a call-in show. 1-800-901-9238, and we'll answer any questions you want about the restaurant, about cooking. Just give us a call. Tell us about the restaurant. How long has it been there?
It's been there. The building's been there since the early 60s.
Really?
Uh-huh.
It was always a restaurant then?
No, it's been. It was an inn at one time, but ever since I've been there, it's been a restaurant.
See, I think I remember when it was an inn because I used to go fishing over there.
That was a long time ago.
Yeah, it was. Yeah. So how long have y'all been operating the restaurant?
I've been there since 1985.
Oh, yeah. Well, you've been there a while.
I have been there a while.
Well, tell us about the cuisine there. I mean, tell us about the menu.
Well, we have a steak and seafood menu. We have grilled quail. We have quite an extensive
grilled
menu.
Grilled quail?
Yes.
Wow,
mm-hmm.
That's neat.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people in the South love that.
Oh, right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Of course, you get your northern visitors and not quite sure what that is, right?
No, but that's why they need to come and see us.
Well, tell us some more about the menu.
Okay. Well, we have we also have a salad bar downstairs, and we have a wide variety. We have soups, like I said, steaks and seafood. We have quail, fingerling catfish, which comes right out of the river.
You know, you got to tell me about this fingerling catfish. Mm-hmm. Now, what's a fingerling catfish?
Well, it's a small catfish. They tend to range about that size. They are best deep fried. I wouldn't cook them any other way, personally.
But, you cook them with the bone in and everything.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Don't you eat the bone and everything?
No, I wouldn't eat the bone. But
I've seen them eat that when they fry them. You know,
I've seen people eat the tails on them. But,
yeah, that's all I was thinking about. Well, do you get a lot of business from people driving around or from the river?
Well, we're kind of a destination. A lot of times motorcycle groups will come out and see us, and also we get groups that come out and do the river tour, which is located at the front of the restaurant on the riverside. So.
Well, here's the restaurant right here, mm-hmm. and we're looking at it. Boy, that's beautiful. Mm-hmm. I see the boats going by, so that's where you get a lot of your customers, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. A lot of people spend the day out on the river and then come and see us for lunch or dinner.
Oh, that's neat. Oh, I'd like to be there right now. Mm-hmm. Look at that. I notice they're having an adult beverage. I get you have a full bar there?
Yes, we have a full bar, beer, wine, liquor, pretty much whatever you want.
Isn't that beautiful? What's this river tour? You all have a river tour there?
Yes, there's a river tour that departs from Blackwater Inn daily. Reservations are recommended, or uh-huh. actually required. And they get to go out onto St. John's River and out to Lake George.
Wow, that's really, really neat. Now, you have the restaurant downstairs and Williams Landing upstairs, you were telling me earlier.
Yes.
Tell me about that.
Yeah, we're kind of two restaurants in one building.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. Downstairs is Blackwater Inn.
Oh, there it is. That's pretty.
And upstairs is Williams Landing, and we have an outside dining area upstairs where you can just sit out there and relax and have a meal and watch the river go by.
Boy, that's really neat. It's mm-hmm. covered and everything, too.
Oh, so. Yeah, yeah.
Boy, I love the way that's set up.
Beautiful setting.
It truly is, and mm-hmm. people are enjoying themselves.
Oh, yeah.
Do you have any special events? You were talking about motorcycle groups go out there. Do you have, like we were talking about, special parties or anything to the restaurant?
Well, we have a banquet room that we can accommodate up to 50 people in there.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
I was just kind of wondering about that. Well, folks, don't forget, this is a call-in show, and it's 1-800-901-9238. If you have any questions about food in general, we'd be happy to answer it for you. and talk about the restaurant. So make sure you give us a holler at 1-800-901-9238. Well, let's keep talking about the restaurant a little bit. We were talking, you said you had a salad bar. I was going through the menu, 30-item salad bar?
Yeah, we got all kinds of stuff on there.
That thing sounds terrific. Mm-hmm.
We got fresh vegetables on there, our own in-house made pea salad.
Come on, tell me about the pea salad now.
Pea salad, it's pretty good. We got people that come far and wide for it.
That's a big Southern dish.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, and we like to think we make one of the best ones.
Well, that's neat. Well, that's why it's Southern cuisine.
Absolutely.
I like the idea.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have any popular items at the restaurant, or do people just kind of generally shop the menu?
They shop the menu. We have a wide variety, so, you know, I can't really say of one thing that people should come out and try, but, you know, we like to think we do a really good job with whatever people order.
Well, we've had some people tell us you have to try the clam chowder.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I don't, you want to verify that or not?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, come out and try the clam chowder. Come out and try our soup of the day.
Well, you were talking about soup of the day. Are there, you know, kind of different items that you serve, or are there specials, or do you change the menu?
We change parts of the menu. We have three additional specials every day, and we have a different soup of the day. Lots of things to try.
That's pretty neat. I like that idea a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Don't forget, folks, our number is 1-800-901-9238, and we're talking to Richard Coleman from Blackwater Inn. I tell you what, I just think it's a neat drive over to St. John. It's so beautiful over
mm-hmm.
there.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I used to go, friends of mine go fishing. You see a lot of gators over there when you're...
Oh, yeah, you could be sitting out there having dinner and watch a gator or a manatee or otters go by. There's all
really,
kinds of wildlife
otters. You know,
out there.
People don't realize there's otters
mm-hmm.
here in Florida.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's kind of neat. I've been fishing a few times. I said, what in the world is that dog doing in the water?
You can sit out there for a while and just something will catch your eye eventually.
When I was growing up, we used to go croaker fishing mm-hmm. over there with a cane pole and everything.
Mm-hmm.
You can catch all you can get. At the salad bar, you know, a lot of people talk about salad bars and healthy eating.
Mm-hmm.
And we were talking before the show, do you have something special for those people, or vegetarian or something?
We have a vegetarian platter on our menu.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, it's a plate of steamed vegetables with sautéed mushrooms that comes with it. And then it also comes with the salad bar.
Now, I noticed you had like a Boca burger.
Yes, we have
that
as well.
My wife loves those things.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as chefs, you know, we were talking about before the show, years ago when somebody would come in and said they were vegetarian, we used to pull our hair out. Go, oh, no, we got to stop what we're doing. But it's become so popular now
yes.
that it's on everybody's menu,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yeah, yeah.
Is there anything special on your vegetable platter that you do, or you just do vegetables of the season?
It's just vegetables with seasoning.
And do people do special dressing for that or anything?
No, it's just a plate of steamed vegetables. So, like I said, we have different varieties of dressings on the salad bar, so...
And I'm surprised how many people just love steamed vegetables.
Mm-hmm.
I go home at night and I cook for my wife and my mother-in-law, and they're always asking for fresh vegetables. I say, how do you want them? Steamed? And I'm going, don't you want something on, some seasoning?
A little variety every so often is okay.
I think that's funny. Listen, we're going to get started here in just a few minutes and cook something. Tonight, I wanted to kind of honor your restaurant a little bit. Okay, here we are at another, before we get started here, is that you working, I think, in the kitchen.
Okay.
And
yeah.
This
is me breading one of our signature dishes. It's our cracker platter.
Cracker platter?
Yes.
And what's on that?
Fingerling catfish, frog legs, and alligator.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Do you get your seafood anywhere special?
We have local suppliers.
Okay. Yeah. That was alligator you had, the little pieces there?
Yeah. We pre-marinate it in buttermilk. And then I bread it in seasoned flour.
You know, a lot of people don't know about that marinating in buttermilk.
Mm-hmm.
Tonight, we're going to make some frog legs.
Okay.
And I had them marinating in buttermilk. Mm-hmm. You know, that tenderizes it and makes... That's a Southern thing.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah, most definitely. Most definitely.
Pretty much fried. There it is. That's a pretty platter.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the frog legs. Woo!
And there's your steamed vegetables.
There you go. That's a beautiful plate. And there's the clam chowder there to the side. That's a beautiful salad, too, by the way. Oh, look at these dishes. They're coming. Now you're making me hungry. That's part of the salad
That's
bar.
That's part of the
There's
salad bar.
There's your pea
There's
salad,
pea
right?
Salad.
You know, many people don't know about pea salad,
mm-hmm.
but that's a big thing here in the South, isn't it?
It's very, very tasty.
Well, we're going to keep on going here. And if you folks will bear with me, in honor of our rest. By the way, this is the menu. It's a really great menu. I was breezing through it, and there's really quite a few things on this menu. I was looking at it, you know, you've got beef, prime rib, you name it. There's all kinds of neat stuff on here. And I can't see where there's anything in here that's not covered. You've got vegetarian, you got crab legs, I mean, salads, sandwiches, hamburgers, man, you got it all.
Yeah, there's a lot to choose from.
I just want to take a moment to review to our viewers that call-in show, so it's 1-800-901-9238. Okay, we're going to bring out these things I told you I'm going to make tonight for you. So I'm going to get some frog legs I have over here. Okay, we have a caller and a question from Blanche. What's your question, Blanche?
Chef, I'm Blanche from Port Orange, and I heard that that restaurant has Danish ribs, and I'm wondering, what is the difference between Danish ribs and just the regular ribs?
Richard?
Well, Danish ribs, they tend to be smaller. I personally think they're very tender. It's a very meaty product.
They really are.
Yeah. They're imported, of course, but it's really delicious. And what we do is we bake them until they're tender, and then we finish them off on the grill with our house sauce, and people just love them.
And they're boneless, right?
No, they're bone-in.
Oh, bone-in. Okay.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of people don't know that the Danes do a lot of pork. I mean, they do the hams and things like that. Mm-hmm. Very well known for that. Okay, right here in front of us we have one of the frog legs. I'm going to hold it up for everybody. Don't get all squeamish on me, okay? This is a frog leg. You know, frog legs, I was really doing some research on frog legs. They're very high in omega-3 oils.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, very healthy for you. You think of salmon, mm-hmm. frog legs have got the same thing. Now, they come like this. Now, what I did is probably what, I don't know if you keep yours whole, but I went ahead and split it.
Yeah, that's what we do.
Okay, and these have been breaded. And so I'm going to turn my cooker on over here. This is my induction stove I was telling you about. It's really something.
Yeah, that's a pretty nice piece of equipment.
It's really amazing how fast it cooks. And so what we have here is I breaded this in, you can do a seasoned breading.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure you were breading in there. I was going to ask you what your secrets were on that. But you said, what did you tell me?
Well, I said there's no secret about the breading. The secret's in the seasoning.
So. There you go. He was going to tell me anyway. I knew that was coming. Well, what I'm doing tonight is kind of a tribute to your restaurant is an Florida orange glaze frog legs.
Okay.
And you just don't see frog legs that often in restaurants.
No, you don't. You don't.
And I thought that was really a nice touch. They're very, very, you know, people ask all the time, how does it taste?
Mm.
I'm going to ask you. I'm not going to say what he says.
Okay.
But what do you think they taste like?
They taste like whatever you bread them in.
Thank you very much. That's exactly what I was thinking. Now, this oil is almost ready to go here, and it doesn't take long. This thing really gets hot fast.
Hmm.
Have a call from, we got a caller on the line. What's your call?
How fresh is your food?
I didn't hear.
I didn't hear that, ma'am. Oh, how fresh is your food?
How fresh is our food? It's as fresh as I can get it. Like I said, the fingerling catfish, for instance, we get right out of the river. It's caught on a daily basis. So
that's pretty neat.
Yeah, the catfish you could be sitting down eating that day could have been caught in the river just the day before.
Okay, and don't forget our number is 1-800-901-9238. And I'm taking this breaded... I use a special breading as well. I'm not going to tell you what seasoning is. But, you know, some people buy their breading already. You know, they use breading already. Mm-hmm. And they have to be careful when they do that because you can't really season that because it's already seasoned.
Right.
And people will go ahead and start seasoning it and say, wait a minute, this thing's too salty or something, you know. So I'm just going to put a few of them in here right now and keep cooking them. What I'm going to do is kind of saute these. That's kind of high heat with some oil. And then I'm going to go ahead and make an orange glaze and put over them after they're cooked. And then once they're cooked, I'm going to put them on this bed of wild rice.
All right.
That's pretty nice. Mm-hmm. I like that. So anyway, we're cooking away. Don't forget our number is 1-800-901-9238. I'm just going to kind of turn these over a little bit. I don't know if you can see this or not.
Now, one thing about frog legs is they have a tendency to want to pop in that hot oil.
You know what? We were just kind of, I was laughing about that because this has happened to me before. When you're cooking frog legs, it has that muscle in the leg, it'll start twitching.
Yeah.
The recipe card is up for this right now. So if you want to look and see what we're doing, it is 1 pound of large frog legs, a cup of all-purpose flour, then you season it the way you want to season. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of brown these real good, and then I'm going to go ahead and make my orange sauce and put right on top of it and finish it off. You don't want to really cook these too long, do you, Chef?
No. Just before we're done, you're almost there.
Well, what I'm going to do is take them out because I'm going to put them back in. And now what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add shallots that I have. That sounds nice when it's cooking.
Oh, yeah.
Especially that. When you're not cooking it
Love
yourself.
Love that sound.
I put parsley in here. And then I have orange juice. And this is all my secret ingredients right here. There's nothing secret about it. There's some Dijon mustard in here. Mm-hmm. And there's, I like that spicy mustard too. I put that in. And there's a little bit of soy sauce, a little bit of honey.
Well,
and that's going to be our glaze.
That smells really good.
Yeah, it really is going to be nice. Once I kind of cook that down, I'm going to put frog legs back in it. And that's going to be the orange glazed frog legs.
Okay.
I just thought it'd be something different you don't normally see, you know. Because I think everybody tries it. And I put a little bit of white wine in that, too. I didn't have any tequila, but I just tried that.
Here, you want some?
Oh, was that what was in that glass? I was wondering. This is cooking down pretty good. Don't forget, folks, 1-800-901-9238. Boy, don't these look good?
Yeah, they look great.
Well, I love that.
The sauce smells amazing.
I'm going to put them right in here and just, that's why I didn't cook them all the way. I was going to kind of finish them off in here. Man, did you smell that?
Mm, that's awesome.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a, almost like an Asian twist
yeah.
to it.
Mm-hmm. It'll go well with that rice.
I was thinking that too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Boy, this whole studio is just filling up with that.
I know, you fill us in here again. Don't forget, folks, 1-800-901-9238. Got a phone call from Anna.
Yes, hello.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing great, great. And you're cooking one of my favorite things, frog legs.
Really?
So I have got to get over to this restaurant, Blackwater Inn.
I'm telling you. You can't find them everywhere. So what was your question for us there? Well, I think she wants to get over to the restaurant because she wants some frog legs.
Yeah, come on down. We do them scampi. We do them Cajun. We do them fried, lemon pepper, all kinds of different ways.
We have another phone call. Sebastian's on the line. Sebastian, what's your question?
I was wondering how long do you marinate the frog legs in buttermilk?
You can marinate them overnight. That's fine. Typically, we like to at least a day, but overnight would be fine.
Yeah, I like that, too. I think that buttermilk really does a trick on those. And see, you can put these just like this. Come on, folks. Tell me that doesn't look good. Richard, what do you think?
It looks great, and it smells great.
Obviously, this isn't a serving. What is a serving on frog legs?
Typically about a half a pound.
Half pound, okay.
Yeah. It makes a good meal. If you don't want that much, you can always back it off a little bit.
I got to turn this off so it doesn't keep cooking.
All right.
Anyway, this is it right here. Richard, I'm going to get something here for you. Here we go. There you are. Now, I didn't heat up the rice quick enough, but if you want to taste the frog legs, please be my guest.
Sure. You know, I like to just dig in and use my hands.
Go ahead. Be my guest.
Because that's the southern way of eating them.
I'm sorry, what was that?
Yeah, that's good.
I have another food call. I got caught up in this food over here. I'm so sorry. And who's the person calling? Danielle, what's your question? What do you think?
Hi, I love your show. I just wanted to know, what do you think is the most popular item on your menu?
Well,
we were kind of talking about that earlier, you know. Richard, what do you think?
It's hard to say. What do I need to do with this?
Here we go. Yep.
I have a napkin. We have a wide variety of stuff. I mean, we cut our steaks in-house, which are very popular. We do prime rib on the weekends. But a lot of people come out for the fingerling catfish. We go through quite a bit of it. Very popular.
I know you go up, you know, Georgia and South Carolina, especially Georgia. There's nothing but catfish houses,
mm-hmm.
and that's all they serve. I thought that was amazing when I see mm-hmm. that, you know. Well, you want to have another one? I'm not going to hold you back
now. I'll dig in.
Don't forget, folks, 1-800-901-9238. Now, we have the brown rice recipe up on the board, if you want to check that out. Very simple. The only thing with brown rice, you have to cook it for a long time. It's not like regular rice. I had to cook this about 40 minutes. Have a call from Etnang. Are you there, caller?
Yes.
Yes, please, I couldn't hear you. I'm cooking on an induction stove, and induction's kind of an interesting, we were talking about that before the show. Induction works like a magnet. So you see I have my hand on this stove and I've been cooking on it. It's not really that hot.
Mm-hmm.
But what happens when you put a steel pan on it, that activates the electricity in it and starts cooking. You take it off, it stops cooking. And that's called induction. It's the same type of science that's involved at Disney World when they have the people mover.
Mm-hmm.
And the people mover is moved by magnets. This works by magnet. There's a positive and negative magnet in there, and it actually, that's what causes it to move.
Okay.
That negative hits the positive and pushes it. Here, it makes contact and it creates heat. It's kind of neat. We're gonna keep on going here. We're gonna do that right now. We're gonna look at our key lime pie. Everybody was talking about key lime pie. Well, here it comes. Okay, Richard. We're gonna make a key lime pie real quick.
Okay, I'm
what
ready.
I have here. I brought some tart shells. You can do just about anything you want. And it's really simple. I can't believe it is so simple to make. Let me get some gloves here because I'm gonna be messing with this a little bit. A key lime pie, this is it. We were talking about it before the show. I went down to Sanibel Island and I was fishing down there with my family, and there was a grocery store that was serving key lime pie every day. And so I asked him for the recipe, and I couldn't believe what the recipe was. And this was it. They use sweetened condensed milk, and I have it right here. Two cans of sweetened condensed milk will make a 9-inch pie. I kind of like doing it in the shells or little, you can use that phyllo dough
mm-hmm.
and put it in there. And I think that works real well. But anyway, here's the thing about this key lime. Key limes from Key West are very acidic. So when you're cooking with it, it really reacts kind of differently than regular lime. Now, I want you to put some key lime juice in here. This is how simple this recipe is. What you have to do, just pour some in.
All right, Chef, say when.
And you just pour. Okay, let's try that. And all you have to do is mix it up. And as you see how thick it's starting to really, that key lime is so acidic, it really kind of starts, see how it's starting to gel?
It's starting to gel pretty quick.
It really does. It's amazing how that key lime works. Now, I'm so sorry. Had these out earlier. Now, what you have to do is taste it and then tell me if it is acidic enough for you. And that's how simple it is.
You're there.
That's it?
That's it.
You just made key lime pie, folks. Now all you have to do is come up here. Let me get this out of the way. And put it right in your pie shells. I mean, look how easy that was. You can make this at home and tell people, it took me all afternoon to make this key lime pie. I sure hope you like it. Okay. Now, folks, each week, this show, we're recommending a wine for our dishes that we have. This week, we're going to, and check the Facebook page because it's on there. This evening's dish, to say that Richard had a nice cold beer with his, we choose cracker powder. So let me fit. Oh, look at that whipped cream. Okay, done deal. All right. So for the sautéed legs with Florida orange butter, I'm going to recommend a Sauvignon Blanc. And that'll be on our Facebook page. Each week we'll be recommending a beer or wine to go with it, okay? Folks, I guess we're going to run out of time here, Richard. I appreciate you coming down.
Oh,
we're all
for
out of time.
Me.
If you didn't get your questions answered, you can email us at daytonastate.edu. And don't forget, like us on Facebook. Come on, tell your friends. I want to thank my guest and friend, Richard Coleman, for joining us. And if you'd like to find out more about Blackwater Inn, you can check out the website at blackwaterinn.com. Join us next time for another episode of Local Flavor Restaurant Edition. And have some fun with us. Thank you, Richard.
Thank you, Chef.
No, you can't eat this right now.
Well, come on.